Welcome back. We'll start with the Kasner forest disease. It is a new type of disease and also called as febrile disease. Which is present in the Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala region. This is what Kasner forest is located. KFD is a febrile disease associated with hemorrhage caused by Kasner forest disease virus, a member of virus family of arbovirus and flavivirus, and transmitted to man by bite of infected ticks. So here ticks are transmitting the virus in this forest area. Okay, that's why it is called Kasner forest disease virus. Okay, this virus is present in the Kasner area of forest, which belong to the arbovirus and the flavivirus group. And the history, KFD was first recognized in 1957 in Shivamogga district of Karnataka states in South India. Local inhabitants called the disease monkey disease because of its association with dead monkeys. Okay, when the disease came, the dead monkeys were dying, so they called it as monkey disease. According to reports, about 400 to 500 cases occur every year. The Karnataka government has established a surveillance system which monitors the occurrence of KFD in humans and mortality in monkeys in non-epidemic areas as well as neighboring areas. Death of monkeys are considered as heralders of this disease in endemic areas. Usually every year there will be 400 to 500 cases. And the Karnataka government is doing the surveillance program. And when the monkey is dying in certain area, they will first look for this disease prevalence. Okay? And epidemiology determined that agent is KFD virus. It is a member of group B toga viruses, that is flaviviruses. It's antigenically related to other tick-borne flaviviruses. A natural host and reservoir, small mammals, particularly rats and squirrels, are the main reservoirs of the virus. Birds and bats are less important hosts. The monkeys are recognized as amplifying hosts for the virus. Okay, monkeys will, in the monkey body, the virus will grow very fast and they will multiply there. Okay, it is a good environment body for the virus. Vector, the virus has complex life cycle involving as wide variety of tick species. Okay, it is for transferring through the ticks. At least 15 species of hard ticks of the genus Haemophilus faecalitis, particularly H. spinigera and H. tortura, those are the tick species, are known to transmit the disease. KFD has also been isolated from soft ticks. Even it is spread by the soft tick also. The highest number of human and monkey infections occur during drier month, that is from January to June. This period coincides with the peak nymphal activity of ticks. Okay, the highest activity of the ticks and the transmission occurs through this season, January to June. And the host factor, age, majority of the cases affected were between 20 to 40 years. And gender, the rate was greater in males than females because they were working in the forest areas. Occupation, the attacked people were mostly cultivators who visited forests accompanying their cattle or cutting woods. Okay, here it's saying occupation means the people who are visiting the forest for the cattle and cutting woods, and they were attacked by the virus. The human activity, the epidemic period correlates well with the period of greatest human activity in the forest, that is from January until the onset of rains in June. Okay, that is the perfect time. During the during this time, the virus activity increases, the activity of tick also increases. At the same time, the human also will be very active in this time, so there will be more transmission during this time. And mode of transmission, the transmission cycle involves mainly monkeys and ticks. The disease is transmitted by the bite of infective ticks, especially in nymphal stages. There is no evidence of man-to-man transmission. Okay, man-to-man transmission is not there, but it is transmitted through the ticks. and the incubation period is 3 to 8 days. And the clinical features, here you will see sudden onset of fever, headache, severe myalgia, that is muscle pain, with the prostration in some patients. The acute phase lasts for about 2 weeks, okay, within 2 weeks the acute phase will be there. Gastrointestinal disturbances will be there, vomiting and diarrhea. Hemorrhages from nose, gum, stomach and intestine may occur in several cases. There will be bleeding from the nose, gums, stomach and intestine. In number of cases, there is a second phase characterized by mild meningoencephalitis after a febrile period of 7 to 21 days. It is manifested by a return of fever. Okay, febrile period means the fever period, that is from the 7 to 21 days. There will be second phase starting. During that time, there will be mild meningoencephalitis. Severe headache followed by neck stiffness, coarse tremors. There will be whole body vibration, tremors will be there. Abnormal reflexes you can see, mental disturbances. The case fatality rate has been estimated to be 5 to 10%. Whoever gets the disease, at least 5 to 10% of the people will die. And the diagnosis, it is established only after detecting the presence of virus in the blood and or serological evidence. And other than that, you will go for ELISA also and PCR chain reaction. Okay. And the treatment, there is no specific treatment, but early hospitalization and supportive therapy can be made good. And supportive therapy includes the maintenance of hydration and usual precaution for patient with the bleeding disorder. Okay, you will treat the hydration if any dehydration is there. Then if the patient is having bleeding disorder, again you will treat them. And vaccine is available for this. Okay. And control, control of ticks. Since KFD is tick-borne disease, control of ticks should be undertaken. For control of ticks in forest, application can be made by power equipment or by aircraft mounted equipment to dispense carbaryl, phenthion, nail or propoxer at 2.24 kg of active ingredient per hectare. Okay. This we are spraying in the forest area where the KFD can be seen. And we can use insect repellent also, and protective clothing we can wear, and health education to the people regarding the prevention and control of the tick. So that's what about the Casmur forest disease. We'll see in the next chapter. Thank you.